So when you blow it up, you've got the force of the balloon going that way, then it propels it then to go that way. So you've got equal and opposite forces.
My name's Tash Colson and I work at Centralian Senior College here in Alice Springs. My subject areas are 10 science, 11 maths, 12 food and hospitality and 11 numeracy. The Year 10 science class is all about making it relevant to the students. One thing about Year 10 is the students have to be here. So you sort of find in some ways of planning and preparation, you need to make it quite engaging for the students that actually don't want to be here and want to be out working. So when I'm looking at curriculum and doing my lesson planning, I need to think, you know, how are they going to use this? So how is this going to be relevant? So when we talked about inertia, which was force, we did a prac on crash test dummies. So they actually modelled little crash test dummies and actually did it. We likened it to car safety. So things to get them engaged and interested actually in the content.
As the balloon gets bigger, it's harder to deliver a full breath into it. So just what this would do to the flight time. So if you still can't put big breaths into it, are you going to have more time in the air?
Not necessarily.
Yeah, because why do you think?
So the questions with the balloon rocket prac will be more, because it's a design prac, it'll be more like guiding. It'll be more sort of, you know, how is that going to work? What if we had another balloon? What if we added some weight? So there'll be more open-ended questions to get them start thinking.
I hope it works this time. Oh, it didn't work.
It did work. It did work. I didn't say anything about using another balloon to take it back. All I said was, it's just got to go back to its original starting point.
To try and get a bit of that student participation, especially with my Year 10s, I like to pose a real-life question and get their feedback.
Who plays tennis? Yep. Do you think that's Newton's third law? So you hit the ball, okay, with your bat, and then the ball hits the bat, then what does the ball do?
But working in groups, I think, is good because being by themselves sometimes, I don't know. Where with a group, they can bounce ideas off each other.
The purpose of the fish line is to help guide the balloon in one direction because the back of the balloon, you know how it's all floppy at the end?
Oh, yeah.
Every time it just flops around, it keeps changing its direction.
And it's just lovely when they're planning to actually hear them talking about, oh, do you think this will work? Oh, no, I don't think that will work. Let's use this. So it's just that conversation of working together and trying things. If it doesn't work, it doesn't matter. Do you know what I mean? They have more to write up in their prac then.
I saw some absolutely amazing problem solving and some really great thinking out of the box type stuff, especially for number 14, where you had to, you know, return the balloon to its original position. It was great. Some ideas I hadn't even thought of. So really well done.
The task we did with the Year 12 cooking was themed around a group task called the Modern Australian Dinner. Them actually taking that role and them actually planning it actually engaged them as well too, because they were going to eat it, like they had to prepare it. They had to give me their recipe list, they had to present it, and then that sort of then gives them life skills, you know, past school as well too. We started off doing a lot of formative work on what some of the tasks would look like. So they've had a lot of practice and a lot of, I could say, success in doing those tasks. So then when we went to do the summative tasks, they had a feeling that they could do them. So that sort of helped them in, you know, being engaged and staying on task.
As a group, because this is our collaborative task, who sort of has taken the lead, do you think, or is it... How's that gone?
I think everyone's worked really well together, so yep. It's been good.
And I think because of the planning that you did prior, where you sort of allocated the task, I think that was really helpful too, wasn't it?
The Year 12s, I think because they're young adults, I like to do it at the start of the year is a lot of relationship stuff, just in terms of, you know, like, you know, have you got a part-time job? What are you into? You know, so I know a lot about what they do. That actually helps, you know, when you're drawing from there for specific content. I make sure I at least talk to everybody every single lesson. I'll make a point that I go to everybody and just sort of touch base. How are you going? You know, have you got any problems with that?
How would I word that?
It's a bit tricky, isn't it? You'd say maybe it gets to a point where you can put no more air into the balloon.
Which limits its flight.
Fantastic.
That's my goal, is to sort of touch base with everybody. Have a conversation so at least they know that you know that they're feeling valued in that class.
How do you ensure that all students are engaged in their learning? What planning and teaching strategies are required in order to have productive group learning. How can teachers make content that may appear remote or abstract to students relevant and interesting?